You can get the biggest Chanel back in the store if you want it. I gave them the drip, they set it up, I got them on it. I bought a new bag, I had the white, so I two-toned them. Taking these drawers, I'm gonna be up until the morning. That ain't your car, you just a lease, you don't own it. If I'm in the club, I got that five on the performing. The back end just came in and out runners. Vibes below, cute shit, they all on us. I'm from Atlanta, where young niggas run shit. I know they hating on me, but I don't need comments. Whenever I tell her to come, she come. Whenever it smoke, we ain't running. Drip too hard, don't stand too close. You gon' fuck around and drown. Off this way, doing all these shows. I've been on the road, I don't care where I go, long as I get paid. Bad little fire, she been on my mind. Soon as I get back, she can stay. Do this all the time, this ain't no surprise. Every other night, another movie get made. Drip too hard, don't stand too close. You gon' fuck around and drown. Off this way, doing all these shows. I've been on the road, I don't care where I go, long as I get paid. Bad little fire, she been on my mind. Soon as I get back, she can stay. All the time, this ain't no surprise. Every other night, another movie get made.
Every other night, another dollar get made. Every other night, start me with a good day. I feel like a child, I got boogers in the face. I'm a dancing in the dollar, this shit is a parade. I don't want your train, I'm gon' want another slave. I had a draw to not too many bitches get saved. TSA arrest me, so I took a private plane. He puts a nigga like a while I'm working on my aim. Drip too hard, charge to the car. It's sending to the ground like a better spell a name. Drip too hard, crushing on the floor. You gon' fuck around and drown, tryin' run a nigga away.
Drip too hard, don't stand too close. You gon' fuck around and drown. Off this way, doing all these shows. I've been on the road, I don't care where I go, long as I get paid. Bad little fire, she been on my mind. Soon as I get back, she can stay. Do this all the time, this ain't no surprise. Every other night, another movie get made. Drip too hard, don't stand too close. You gon' fuck around and drown. Off this way, doing all these shows. I've been on the road, I don't care where I go, long as I get paid. Bad little fire, she been on my mind. Soon as I get back, she can stay. All the time, this ain't no surprise. Every other night, another movie get made.
Oh my goodness, I look so pale. Okay, guys, so it is. I didn't really vlog yesterday. I think I did a couple clips of like me in the morning getting myself ready to go out for the day. And then like I didn't really vlog that much yesterday, but we did get brunch. We went to Southern Gentleman. I would not recommend going there. Their drinks were great. The mimosas were great. Their other drinks they had were great, but the food, I just didn't really like my food personally. I probably wouldn't go back there, but now I'm going to meet my friend. It's Sunday. I'm going to meet my friend at First Watch and get some breakfast because I haven't seen her in a minute, and she's about to be leaving, so I'm not going to see her for a while. So I was like, well, let's go get breakfast. But I'm just wearing, oh, there's a squirrel. I'm just wearing like no makeup. Like I have one lash left. Hair's in a bun. I'm wearing my flannel from Pretty Little Things. Honestly, this flannel was probably like $40-something, but it was so worth it because I wear it all the time. So if you love flannels and you don't mind paying a little bit of money for a flannel, this is perfect. Just this long sleeve, like high neck kind of shirt. It's from H&M. I got this like last year. And then I just have on these, say hello to my fupa. I just have on these Fashion Nova leggings. So I'm wearing this like, what is it called, a brown monochromatic outfit. Okay, guys, I hate this glare, but it's been a minute. I've been a really bad vlogger. I've just been a bad YouTuber recently, honestly, if we're being honest. I've just been like going through the motions of life, and I don't necessarily like sharing those. Really, it looks like I'm crying, my eyes are just watery, I don't know why. I'm still kind of uncomfortable sharing some of the most vulnerable moments within myself, because like I guess my thing is like, how am I supposed to help other people or give people advice when I don't even feel like I can help myself right now, if that makes sense. But we're learning, honey, we are learning. I don't know why it looks like I'm crying. My eyes are so glossy right now. I don't know why, but I'm about to get on the road and go to breakfast, and we're gonna have a great day. I think me and my sister are gonna go to the pumpkin patch later. I'm like, oh my god, October's almost over and I haven't done anything. Like I've done nothing fall related or like festive at all, and I normally really like the fall time. I've just, we can talk about it later. So I guess this is turning into more of a weekly vlog, because yesterday I said I was gonna vlog when I came home and I didn't. I sure didn't. Right now, obviously, it's almost 8 o'clock in the morning. I'm making my breakfast essential. So I'm making my coffee. I just did this K-cup stuff. Newman's Own, like, whatever. I'm gonna go in with some vanilla syrup, just so my coffee can have a little bit of flavor. It's sugar free. But where did I leave off yesterday? This is gonna be an interesting vlog, because I don't want to say I don't do much during the week, but like, I literally go to work, I'll come home, I'll either relax, or like yesterday I came home and I went on a little walk, because I just feel better when I exercise, and I honestly feel better. So I'm probably gonna do the same thing today. I would go to the gym, but honestly, guys, after I get off work and, you know, the traffic and everything here, I'm just like, do I want to drive 30 minutes to the gym? Like, it's gonna take me that long to get there. I just be like, nah, so I just go on a walk, but that's not really gonna get me to my, I mean, that's a lie. That, it's not that it won't get me to my goals. I just haven't really been serious about the gym, if we're being honest. I just kind of work out when I feel like it, not overthinking it, not putting too much pressure on myself to look a certain way. So there's that. But yeah, today's Tuesday. I work 9 to 5. So yeah, guys, yesterday I was just really emotional. Like, why am I struggling so much with this? Okay, that's not working. There we go. Yesterday I was just really emotional. Like, it's the time of the month, but I've been going through some things within myself. When am I not? But yeah, I was just like in the motions, and I just felt like crying yesterday. Yeah, so there's that. But I just wanted to make this really like realistic vlog about life. But basically, guys, I don't know what's going on. I don't want to say I don't know what's going on, but I feel like, I just feel like I've been in this, this space of, I can finally put myself first, and I don't know how to do that. Ever since I was younger, I've had to take care of other people. I had to grow up really fast at like a super young age. So now that I'm older, I'm 22, and now that I'm in a position where I'm like, okay, Hunter, you can kind of do your own thing now. Like, you need to live your life for you. I'm struggling with Jesus. There's like nowhere aesthetically pleasing for me to put my phone. I've been struggling with just putting myself first and realizing that I'm living my own life and I can really do whatever I want now. Oh my god, coffee tastes amazing. I just feel like for the past, I'm 22, all my life, I have had to put other people in front of me, and I've had to take care of other people. You know, I had to grow up at a really young age and take on a lot of responsibility that kids my age shouldn't have to take on. And I'm so conditioned to taking care of other people. I'm so conditioned to like being the mom. I'm now at a place where I'm like, everyone's telling me like, no, Hunter, like, you need to live your life for yourself. You need to do what makes you happy. And so I've just been in this fog because I'm trying to figure out what makes me happy, or I have an idea of what makes me happy, but I'm not sure. And then I'm going through this whole job thing of like not being 100%. I mean, obviously the job I'm working right now at 22 is not gonna be the job I'm working for the rest of my life. But it's just like those in-between transitional phases where I'm just like, I don't feel like I'm where I'm supposed to be. I'm really hard on myself, all this other stuff, but I can go deeper into it. I've been thinking about making a separate video where I specifically talk about finally putting yourself first and just the hard emotional realities that come with that if you're a person who had to live their life where you had to constantly put other people in front of you, or like you constantly always had to care or worry about other people and you kind of put yourself on the back burner type thing. So yeah, there's just a lot going on. I will be moving again, so there's that. It's just a lot. But I have been looking for a therapist, which is something I haven't done since I was a sophomore in college. The last time I like talked to somebody was when I was a sophomore in college. That's kind of when I was like, I had a moment where I was like, yeah, I'm not okay. I need to talk to somebody, because I'm the type of person where like, I'll normally just like keep everything in. I feel guilty venting to people about the things I go through, because I know that it's a lot, but also like, I don't expect people to understand. Like, you can't expect everybody to understand what you go through, because everyone goes through their own individual things, obviously. But yeah, I've been looking for a therapist, just because I feel like it's important for everyone to have that outlet, everyone to have that other person to talk to, that other person who knows nothing about you, that other person who doesn't know your friends, doesn't know your family, like, they don't have a biased opinion about you before they meet you, because they don't know you. They don't, you know what I mean? So we're doing that, guys. Healing. Healing. But it's taken a lot for me to kind of just acknowledge that I have some things I need to work on within myself. So I'm just gonna give myself time. I've been like trying to rush myself to figure out like what I need to do. And I really, like, last night, I just had a realization, like, Hunter, you just need to let yourself live. I need to just let myself figure it out. I need to take so much more time to just let myself discover my own happiness again and discover what Hunter wants again. Because I have an idea of what I want, but I don't really feel like I know 100% what I want. So yeah, but anyways, I'm making breakfast before I go to work. For lunch, actually, I have these rice and just dumplings. So I'll eat that. I don't normally pack like another snack. For breakfast, I'm just gonna heat up these waffles. I have coffee. And then I also have the other juice I showed you guys the night before. And I'm gonna put that in a cup and drink that too. But yeah, guys. This is gonna be like a weird vlog. I don't even know what I'm gonna name this. October 21st. I got home from work. I'm about to shower and do some things online that I need to do that I'm not gonna talk about yet until it's happened. But don't you guys love this scrunchie? Isn't this cute? From Target. Halloween. Can't help myself. But yeah, I'm about to shower. This is probably gonna be the ending of my vlog. I know I titled this like October vlog, but this has been most of the month. This has been most of the month. I know we got one more week left, but I'm probably gonna end it here. But yeah, I'm gonna take a shower and then I'm gonna talk to you guys a little bit more, and then that will be the end of the vlog. So yeah, I'm about to shower and get out of my work clothes, because gross, I feel nasty. It's time to shower. Hey guys, so I just got out of the shower, and yeah, so I'm kind of ending the vlog now. But yeah guys, I just really wanted this to be, I feel like I say this in a lot of my videos, I just really want this to be like a realistic vlog recap of my month, because I haven't posted on YouTube recently. And I know that's been a goal for myself, to be really consistent. And I was really consistent for a while, and then I kind of hit a wall. But I just really wanted this video just to show, like, I'm human, we're all human beings. And I just wanted to show, like, there's highlights of my life, as you could see in the beginning of the vlog, like the certain parts of it where it's very cute and it's like me, you know, walking, or like me going to Target or getting drinks or out at restaurants. Like all that stuff is cute, but at the same time I also wanted to show you guys and incorporate the moments where I feel the most vulnerable, or the moments where I'm talking about things that are hard for me to talk about, like when I was in my car, like when I was, you know, getting ready in the morning before I go to work, like just having real ass conversations with you guys, because I feel like there's so much cap on the internet, and it's so easily to fall into this cycle of thinking that, or striving for perfection when perfection is not a thing, or striving for this, or always never being happy while you're in the present moment. Something that I've noticed is like healing and finding yourself and loving yourself, it's not linear, like nothing, it's not going to be this straight line. Like there's going to be ups and there's going to be downs. And a YouTuber that I watched, she was talking about how I think her name's Lynette Adkins, I may have butchered her first name, she was talking about how you have to embrace the basically the valleys of your life, so like the ups and downs, the in-betweens, the ups and downs. You have to learn to be happy in those moments, because I feel like we live in a society, or we live in a society where we're constantly like not happy with where we are, and I don't think we give ourselves enough credit for where we are and just saying, you know what, I'm proud of you. I'm proud of you for making it this far. Like I feel like in society it's so like you need to have all your shit together by like 22 or 21 or however old, and it's like that's not reality. And I can say for myself, I've fallen victim to this ideology that I have to have everything figured out right now, and I'm not really comfortable with saying that I don't have it figured out, because I do not. Hunter does not. But anyways, yeah, I hope you guys enjoy this video. I'm gonna try and maybe do more videos like this, where I kind of combined a bunch of videos from the month and do kind of like a monthly recap, a monthly check-in with you guys, like stuff like that. But like always, please feel free in the comments to talk about how you've been doing personally. I kind of feel like there's just a shift in energy where a lot of people are feeling a lot of emotions, or a lot of people are becoming more aware of how they feel and just stuff like that. So I would love to have a conversation with you guys in the comments, or you guys can follow me on my other social media platforms like TikTok, which I use the most, and I have Instagram and all that other stuff. But like always, thank you guys again for watching me and supporting me and just all that good stuff, and I will see you guys next time. The next time I pick up the camera and I film, which I'm gonna do this weekend, I promise. I'm gonna force myself, because this is healthy for me. Like me talking to you guys is actually healthy for me, so I need to make it a more of a priority now to film more. So yeah guys, talk to y'all later.